The real reason I wanted to do this was edited out of the documentary. I wanted to do this because I have a son and a daughter, and there is nothing in the world like the first giggle. If you have a baby and you really, really want a child, and the first time you tickle them and you get that giggle, it's an emotional high that, it's a high that nothing else could cause. Or the first Christmas, when they get old enough to really say, Mom, Dad, you know, I want this. And then they get it for Christmas, and that emotion or that delight on their face. I think anybody who needs or wants a child deserves to have that kind of emotion, deserves to get what they want. And so that's why I decided to be a gestational carrier. One of the reasons that I told them, they said, now what, why do you want to do this? And I said, because I cannot wait to be 8 months pregnant, walking through the store or somewhere in public, my husband and I, and they, someone come up and go, oh, you know, people want to touch a pregnant lady's belly. Oh, what are you doing? And I can't wait to say, I don't know, it doesn't belong to me. And I even had my husband train. One of my best memories. Tony and Gary came down from one of the doctor's appointments, and we took them to an outdoor drive-in movie. And I ran into an old colleague. And he knows me, he knows my husband, he knows my kids. And he walked over, he said, I didn't know you were going to have another baby. And my husband said, or he said something to my husband about, you know, don't think three, you know, you're going to have your hands full. And my husband just took my cue. He said, it's not mine. And of course, my ex-colleague looked at me and he said, I didn't know you were separated. And I said, no, we didn't. As a matter of fact, it belongs to one of those two guys sitting over there. We just don't know which one, so we bring them with us everywhere. We had a lot of fun with it. But one of the challenges that I faced was I am from the South. And surrogacy is not something that everybody knows about. And trust me when I say, it is nothing like the movie Baby Mom. Because everybody go, oh yeah, I saw that movie. No, nothing like that. So I faced the challenge of educating people. And I had to take the cue, you know, the personal cue from whoever was asking me. Do I want to tell them the whole story or do I want to tell them bits and pieces? Just enough to, I guess, quench their thirst for knowledge. Do I want to tell them that I'm a gestational carrier for a same-sex couple? Or do I just want to say I'm carrying a baby for some friends who can't have babies? Because that's what it is. We were friends before we ever officially started, I think. My kids attached to Tony and Gary immediately. And when they left after the first weekend, my kids were upset. When will they come back? And they're still, my kids call Tony and Gary Dad, Gary, Pop, Tom. So they have more than one father figure, I guess. Which is, it's kind of strange for people who are outside the relationship. But I think overall, I'm so glad, I'm delighted that I did this and that we extended our family. I wouldn't do it with any other. I mean, even with the ups and downs of CNN, I don't think I would change the journey like that. So when you go into something with media, you kind of have to think it's going to get edited to create a story, and it was. People have told me it's not that bad. The story wasn't edited that much. The thought never occurred to me that I was going to eventually have to explain to an 8 and a 3-year-old what was going on. And for a while I didn't. And my son took a growth spurt, started gaining weight, and he looked at me one day and he said, Mom, we're all getting fat. We need to go run. And so I said, okay, let's go run. And mine's not going anywhere, but I didn't approach it immediately. And I think he kind of just got it. He remembered from when my my daughter was born, and he just got it one day. And somebody asked him, he was getting a haircut, the girl asked him, is your mommy going to give you a new brother or sister? And I did like the head snap, like, what's he going to say? And he, I guess he had heard us talking to other adults, which was unfair to him. And he said, no, she's not giving it to us. She's carrying it for some, she's babysitting it for somebody else until it can breathe on its own. And Tony and Gary were uncle, Tony and Gary. And it just, they just, like I had said earlier, they just fell into the family. So I do think that you should speak to your kids about it. I didn't, and it worked out well, because when I went to the hospital, another important thing to me was for my children not to be affected at all. So my husband stayed at home. My mom took me to the hospital, and I told him, leave them in the bed. Of course, because I went into labor in the middle of the night, I said, leave them in the bed when they get up, feed them breakfast, and have an extra special day to tell them I'm busy at school. And so they didn't meet Nicholas until May. He was born in September, and they met him for the first time in May. We made the trip to meet them. And at that time, by that time, I had enough time to process the way that I was feeling and help them process the way that everything was happening. But I did explain to them that I had one perfect boy and one perfect girl, and somebody else needed a perfect baby. And so my son, he just got it. But having Tony here for the emotional support, they would call and say, well, at the time it was annoying, which is what I said in the beginning. They would call and say, okay, it's 18 weeks, this is what you're feeling, and the baby is this size. And I think we had an in-depth conversation about what exactly is a kumquat and how big is it? Because he read in a book, your embryo is the size of a kumquat. So he called and said, what is it? What does it look like? And how big is it? So, which at the time was like, oh, I know what's going on in my body. But it was really good to know that these guys were interested. It wasn't like they were, you're just doing this as a job and, you know, you're working for me. It was really good to know that they were genuinely interested in the process.